In 2016 in Earlywood. The person who has never played poker in her life was Maria Konnikova. She doesn't even find out how many cards must be found in the deck. Therefore, how did she influence Eric Seidel, who was a Globe winner poker player, to be her guide? On the contrary to other poker hopes, Maria wasn't concerned about earning millions. Rather, as an author with a doctorate in psychology, she was concerned about comprehending what poker could inform her about life and its vagueness. And thus, under the leadership of Seidel and other poker specialists, it was departed by her for a year of education in working out for the World Series of Poker or WSOP. This sum indicates to you how Maria turned from beginner to poker to a high-winning champion and the teachings she found out in the meantime. Thanks to this summary, you are going to find out the 30-year career of Eric Seidel kept going with erudition and so, which erudition was used, why cannot your bluffs be hidden by a poker look, and how to resist when the probabilities are opposite to you. Chapter 1: What reflects our probability universe is a kind of widespread poker which is called Unlimited Texas Hold'em. In Unlimited Texas Hold'em, two cards are given to every player like face down. Common cards are also placed face up in the middle of the table. Before the three community cards are distributed, the initial betting round is recognized as the flop. During the game, two extra common cards are put on the table. In a tourney, what symbolizes a player's economic portion in the game is poker chips. The target is to earn as many chips as probable. While you move clockwise around the table, every gamer has to choose whether to play or not, which indicates you throw your hand. Provided that you select to play your papers, you own the selection to search or match the previous stake amount. Or you can increase it, which defines increasing the quantity of the previous wager. During the four rounds of betting, you can try to guess how your cards stack up relied on their action against other players' cards. In the end, the person who wins the play is the gamer who keeps the best hand of the cards or does not fold. The most famous kind of poker is No Boundary Texas Hold'em. However, it was selected to keep going with this particular game by her since of its regular life parallels. One of the properties that separate Unlimited Texas Hold'em from other types of poker is the equilibrium between recognized and unknown factors. You possess sufficient knowledge between your two cards and your common cards, therefore the play is not completely raging. Meantime, there is nothing exact about the game, even if it is learned by you as the mathematical probabilities of exact hands. What gets it a balanced game between talent and luck is the resulting proportion between recognized and unknown factors. It was discussed that poker reflects the universe of probability that rules our daily lives by the 20th century mathematician, John von Neumann. A different distinctive property of No Limit Texas Hold'em is that there is no boundary to the quantity you can wager. In any round of the game, you can bet all in, which indicates you put all your chips into the bowl. Life is likewise a high-risk, large-reward effort. Nothing prevents us from funding investment with the entire of our cash, our hearts, and even our vita itself, on investments that own no guarantee. Provided that you are worried about the rules of poker, don't concern. This is a complicated play. By even Maria, months of meticulousness were spent as work to fully comprehend it. Fortunately, you don't have to be an expert poker player to utilize his erudition to your rulebook. Chapter 2: The latchkey to finding out how to win is losing decently. Providing that you're looking to find out a novel talent, finding a great trainer is the best realm to begin. The person who has the fourth highest competition career in poker history is Eric Seidel, who was Maria's coach. He also owns a place in the Poker Hall of Famous. In different vocabs, Eric Seidel comprehends how to succeed to be a winner. It was ultimately gone bankrupt or spent all their winnings by many poker winners. However, during the publication time, Eric was the person who was still throughout for over 30 years. He was considered by some as being the best poker gamer of all time. Therefore, what is the mystery of its permanent accomplishment? It seems Eric's power is not just to win, but to apprehend how to lose it. When it came to training Maria on the fundamentals of poker, she was sent to meet with Dan Harrington by him. The person who typed the classic poker textbook Harrington on Hold'em was Dan Harrington. In the book, the variety of playing types in poker was detailed by Harrington. However, personally, his proposal was more philosophical. It was said by him that to conquer Pac. Maria must first win herself. And he meant finding out by winning herself, losing her weaknesses once and again. Failure is the most excellent mentor when it comes to specializing a novel talent. It risks early victory, overconfidence, or daydreaming. However, failure pushes you to analyze your process so you can keep going to discover and raise. In poker, the talent to be neutral about your circumstance comes in particularly handy when you get a losing hand through the play. The latchkey to pursuing a career, in the long run, is finding out the art of failing. What is still in the game is that he can fail beautifully, and the group again is one of the reasons Eric. It is taken by many different gamers as the loss as an individual failure and takes the guilt away from them. However, it is being continued by Eric to look at the failures as a training occasion. What is a talent Eric applying at and outside the poker tables is failing excellently. In 1987, Eric's Wall Street job was lost by him after the funds market collision, just as his wife became impregnated. Rather than swimming in misfortune, he evaluated his selections again. He started studying poker because he was a talented backgammon gamer. It wasn't too before he began accomplishing and earning a title for himself as a universal poker winner. Chapter 3: What defines not worrying about what others consider of you as playing wisely? When Maria started her trip training poker in the autumn of 2016, her life in New York City took on a fresh habit. She attended Eric for a hike near her residence on the Upper West Side a few days a week. She was going to New Jersey by train when she was not seeing Eric. In there, the legal game is online gambling, and she used to play poker on her laptop at several cafes. Thanks to online poker, beginner players need to practice without possessing to visit live tournaments. Also, Maria's plays with Eric could be recorded to view again her hands by her. Maria made an early wager utilizing a valet and a 10 in one of her online matches and finally got a hand named an open finished game. There are several paths she can play in this game. However, alternatively, she concentrated on hiding the case that she was a beginner. She had to endure soon after. After that, it was asked by Eric why she was wagering on valet on so early in the game. Her logic was that he said Jack 10 was a great drawing hand. And hadn't she earned it already? The instant that the vocabs came out of her mouth, she recalled a different part of Eric's advice. What would be to hold her place and look at how different gamers act before playing those cards as a more appropriate strategy. Instead of making her judgments, she embraced certainty, increasing the jack on the basis that it was a good hand. The case is that Maria had no solid rationale for any of her judgments. She had been busy inducing Eric that she wasn't a bad mark actor. Meantime, all that was desired by Eric was to cautiously consider every judgment. After a few weeks, Maria got an offer to write a journal writing for a small amount. In the past, it was immediately asked by her for more cash from the exact editor, and she was rejected. However, she said she didn't do a lot of freelance jobs this time because she was operating on the book. It was proposed to Maria more cash by the editor for the first time, expecting to play her cards. Chapter 4: The thing that impacts your kind of play can be social conditioning. With a history in psychology, Maria had some opinions concerning the masculine globe she entered. She had read the research that found that in online poker, boys wager 6% more frequently when another player's image was female. Keeping the info in mind, the online poker username, the Psych Chic, was named by Maria. With that approach, she could make ready herself for the facts of how to act in live poker competitions. How her social circumstances as a woman affected her performance at the poker table was what she didn't apprehend until much later. A total newcomer to the game of poker, Maria thought she owned a benefit. She had no worse routines or pre-thought models. It was a blank slate ready to find out from the most excellent brains in the play. Yet as it turned to play, she combated with applying an offensive kind. Eric stated that she should revive her inflexibility in her initial live competition in New York. For instance, rather than passing, she must think of wagering in exact circumstances. He recommended that using a thrusting kind of play might be a benefit. Why is that? Because gamblers who are male probably think a woman can't make thrusting actions. Eventually, it was realized by Maria that her loss to play aggressively was due to her social conditioning as a female. It was not a gap page in the past. Rather, she had improved a lifelong internalized attitude to the game, found out from a Globe that penalized women for acting aggressively. In the research by Hannah Riley Bowles, an elder lecturer at the Kennedy School of Government at Harvard, it was found that females in leadership situations are recognized more negatively than their man counterparts when behaving assertively. Consequently, the sex that is adapted to act passively is female. Being an accomplished writer with a doctorate in psychology, it was believed by Maria that she had come through this social circumstance. However, what demonstrated to her that was not the situation was playing poker. Initially, this awareness was so hurting that she even thought of finishing her poker effort. However, after a night's sleep, she sensed she was revived to defy clichés and establish herself as a deserving winner. Chapter 5: Instead of concentrating on the cards that you are distributed, concentrate on how you play. In the wintertime of 2017, 6 months ere the WSOP, it occurred her initial trip to Las Vegas to play live poker every day by Maria. The instant that she landed in Vegas, she started planning to go to casinos such as the famous Caesars and MGM Grand. However, Eric immediately led her to casinos where the entrances are at their level. The little shock to her ego lessened when she comprehended how much she still needed to find out. Maria managed to keep in the top four in a little $60 tournament at Bally's Gaming House. She got excited when she saw herself as an obtained set of nine with a great hand and made an all-in wager. However, as soon as she imagined she was going to earn her initial tournament money, it showed up that someone had a more appropriate card hand to win this. Maria was caught. Returning to Aria's more reputable poker court, Maria gave Eric a break during a $25,000 buy-in play. Although she started to rekindle her destruction, she was interrupted by Eric. Did she own a problem with how she played? Not specifically, but before she began explaining the cards distributed to her, she replied. When again, she was unusually stopped by Eric. He said she wasn't affected provided that she had no issues about how she played. It was demonstrated by Eric that it is a worse intellectual routine to get caught up in bad wagers or hands that look great but still lose. He told her to concentrate on Maria's process rather than center on chance. Thinking about the recommendation and later, it was thought by Maria about how our notions about chance impact our feelings, judgments, and worldview. She perceived that resistance assisted us to come through past mishaps and better make ready for the future. Your behavior to bad chance is important in poker. Do you consider yourself the sufferer of bad chance or the winner of making the most excellent judgment under difficult situations? In the worst position, when you come across a bad chance, you can turn around to believe that the trial was for nothing. The exact thing can be told for life, provided that you concentrate too much on chance, you can roll in your misfortune. Rather, concentrate on the elements of your life that you can have authority and discover occasions to move ahead. Chapter 6: Make try-on better by concentrating on your enforcement instead of your face. In 2013, it was managed a study that handled videos of expert poker gamblers at the 2009 WSOP by a graduate student at Tufts University. The aim was to discover how human beings behave while attempting to hold mysteries. In the study, it was asked undergraduate pupils to predict how well a hand has relied on the player's attitude. In some videos, it has been switched to show only one gambler's face. Different videos were cut to indicate just the arms of a gamer. It is understood by most of us that wagering is about keeping a great poker face. However, the research at Tufts showed up that a gamer's face didn't talk much about their cards. During it, participants saw clipped hand videos, they were more precisely reading how powerful or poor a gambler's cards were. The truth that a poker face is not a winning poker player was open to Maria. Having a blank face becomes tiring practice after hours of playing in a tourney. However, she was culpable of venturing to read her rivals when they seemed right away. Frequently, these readings relied on her elusive prejudice. Concentrating on different individuals' hands is one of the stuff you can get to comprehend their cards. However, Maria desired to get her wager less pronounced. Therefore, she debated with Blake Eastman, an attitude analyst and previous poker player. It was analyzed by Eastman in hours of videos starring Maria. He explained that she has a routine of con. Trolling her cards again. This meant that the hand was too complex to recall at a look. Maria also tended to play very coherently in the early night. What converted an indicator was any deviation from her attitude, especially when she was tired later in a competition. It was proposed by Eastman that rather than trying to move robotically throughout the entire game, she concentrated on being constant in performance. He gave a bit of advice to her to stop at each move, not only when she was considering more. Pushing herself to stop assists her to fight tiredness and maintain her performance throughout the night. Chapter 7: The place where Maria was unable to exercise the art of quitting was the WSOP. When Maria departs on her trip, mastering the art and joining the WSOP in Las Vegas within a year were her aims. In the end, 1 year fit the target of the book she was typing. The issue was that WSOP 2017 wasn't a decent 12 months away. While she started playing in early autumn, she was just 7 months away from the June event. Well, sure, in Monte Carlo at 193rd place, €1,100, approximately $1,300, was starting to perform better in some tourneys, involving the national championship. However, in the weeks guiding up to June, it became progressively apparent that he was not fully prepared for the $10,000 entry in the WSOP main event. She still desired to make it. Rather than questioning Eric if she was prepared, she told him she would play. In looking back, Maria should have thought about her situation, just as the poker specialists educated her. The WSOP did not desire to face this situation and embrace it, although it was 5 months ahead of its initial deadline. Sincere down, she desired to get money and obtain the compliment of specializing in poker in less than a year. Maria made a decision to play. Even when she sensed migraine symptoms early on the morning time of the opening day, she did not withdraw from the $10,000 investment. An hour's Maria arrived at the event before she puked on the bath floor of the Rio Hotel and Casino. Due to the right to participate in each round, when she returned to the table, her chips were low in her absenteeism. She handled to get by the second day with a little chance. However, at this dot, her performance fell apart. As she owned one of the best cards during distribution, she lifted it ahead of time, outwardly pausing to consider. Later, when a rival's attitude showed that he had a powerful hand, she called it instead of passing. It shows up that the rival is holding the nut flush with the greatest potential card hand. In different vocabs, Maria needed to leave the tourney. Chapter 8: Predict your trends to concentrate on at the moment. What demonstrated to be more than just practice was Maria's year of poker. After the WSOP, it was not owned by her that aim of discontinuance, the play that had given her so many life courses. She also comprehended she needed to evaluate again. Therefore, she accepted the proposal of a psychologist and mental game mentor, Jared Tendler, to negotiate with him for several sessions. Unless her history as a psychologist was sufficient for her to specialize in poker, maybe he'd have a second view. While you sit at the poker desk, you take your entire passionate burden with you. You're just a person at all at the final of the day. Therefore, provided that you desire to play your most excellent game, you are required to comprehend your feelings before it impacts the path you play. With practice, it can be anticipated by you that the feelings a circumstance may trigger and refocus your decision-making process. It was given by Tendler to Maria as an exercise to recognize feeling triggers and the reactions, opinions, or actions they induced during the game. Her best was to pinpoint the fundamental induce of these triggers. She would later record a report that he could refer to when a difficult circumstance arises. After some thought, it was understood by Maria that most of the feelings of distress that affected her playing were spurred by men, especially those that bothered her with undesired attention or patronizing recommendation. In one case, it was asked to her by a Texas guy for a drink and kept going to offer her long after she said to him that she was espoused during the match. He even raised that his boy was dead before she questioned once more. When the ground denied moving him to a different desk, the anger she sensed induced her to fail one pot and leave the tournament. Fortunately, it was discovered by Maria as a basic solution to get out of alike circumstances. In the future, she could wear a couple of rumble cancellation headphones before her feeling response spoiled her game. Realizing that even the winner gamers are only individuals, Maria managed to come through the sense that they don't fit poker. and when she earned self-esteem, she gradually started to develop at the tables. She came in the 20th, about $2,500 at a €2,200 participation happening in Prague. And in no time at all, she earned her initial big global name in January 2018, taking home $84,600 as being the PokerStars Caribbean Adventure National winner in 2018. The Biggest Bluff, How I Learned to Pay Attention, Master Myself, and Win by Maria Konnikova book review during the most skilled specialists in the realm assisting Maria Konnikova's trip to poker, the final mastery of Texas Hold'em came when she returned to study her inner opinion processes. What explains cases that can be utilized both on poker tables and off poker tables is Konnikova's examination of talent and luck. By concentrating on improving our talents, considering and performing instead of the cards dealt with us, we can overcome life's tough times and be up to when a chance is on our team once more.